court in front of CitiBank or Citigroup or Citicorp, it's all the same thing. This bank is significant because it played a key role in the mortgage crisis of 2008, which of course was tied to the housing crisis and the economic meltdown. They received a huge stimulus package from the government. But yet at the same time, they also had an enormous amount of cash reserves. Something doesn't add up in this case. This is one of the most egregious companies on Wall Street. And on top of all that, they've also had massive layoffs as well as restructuring to their company. What's interesting about Citibank, however, is that they support a lot of so-called left-of-center politicians. But they also have supported Republican and right-wing politicians as well. I believe 2006 to 2011, they spent about $23 million to support the right wing. So very, very savvy players in the whole economic meltdown of 2008. And, you know, we really have to ask the question of, you know, they got this massive amount of surplus funds or bailout funds from the government, but yet they are heavily involved in the political process in terms of supporting candidates and money inside of politics. So I think people need to do their own independent research. But if you look at the money that they've received from the government, as well as the money that they put out to government officials, particularly politicians, I think you'll see how exactly money in politics actually works. Citigroup, Citicorp, Citibank, all the same thing. And of course, they're less than, two blocks away from the South Street Seaport. And they also play a role in the slave trade as well. We're right off the East River, too. So there's a lot of significance about this area, Wall Street, in terms of not only like the economic situation we're going through now, but the slave trade. So I just ask people that are watching this, whenever this gets broadcast, do your own. Don't just listen to what I'm saying. Do your own research. And the more that you'll find out, the more you'll be like scratching your head, wondering, like, wow, the average person needs to know this information. Instead of bailing out, the government could have bailed out the people. But instead, they're giving all this money to Wall Street instead of Main Street. And I think that's what, you know, gave rise to the Occupy Wall Street movement. Why aren't the people being bailed out? And a lot of this started under Bush's watch. Obama inherited it. But really, Clinton, you know, helped to get the ball rolling in terms of the housing meltdown when he, you know, pushed through this thing to make sure that 90% of people were able to get loans or mortgages to help with their mortgages. And basically what happened was a lot of these big companies, these big banks knew that a lot of these people couldn't afford to pay it back, but they had government money that was guaranteed. You know, a lot of greed, a lot of corruption going on, and very, 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 very few people have been prosecuted for the particular, you know, crimes that they have committed. Citibank, like Bank of America, we did have some occupations of Citibank. We have done some demonstrations. We have done, but mostly it's been move your money. We've had occupiers that have slept inside of the vestibules where they have ATMs after we were kicked out of Zuccotti Park. Not enough actions, I think, but we have had actions against this bank as well. And we're right down the street, of course, from Trinity, where we actually have a physical occupation going on right now. This is also considered one of the too big to fail banks. And right now, I didn't mention this, but there's five banks in America that have over 58%. That own 58% of the assets of this economy. Wells Fargo, Citibank, Bank of America, I believe the Bank of New York, and Goldman Sachs. Citibank received a credit line of $45 billion from the U.S. Treasury Department, and Also, the government would guarantee losses on more than $300 billion and inject $20 billion into the company. In exchange, the salary of the CEO is now supposedly $1 a year, and the highest salary of employees is restricted to $500,000. But despite all of that, Citibank built an enormous cash reserve in the wake of the financial crisis of $42 billion in surplus cash. Something doesn't quite add up. How do you have that amount of cash in surplus cash and yet you still need all of these bailout funds? Trickle-down theory, run amok.